Another strike in Portugal. This time, metro workers bring the entire underground system to a standstill. The Eurozone's peripheral countries are still struggling almost daily with protests, but a new report suggests the tide is changing, or at least sentiment is. Dutch bank ING says around 93 billion euros of private investment was pumped into the periphery in the last 3 months of 2012. That's a stark contrast to the previous 4 years, which saw investors abandoning debt-ridden countries such as Greece and Spain. Senior economist at ING, Martin van Vliet, says the ECB is behind the market.
In early August, obviously, the ECB promised to buy an unlimited amount of bonds if necessary. And I think the threat of unlimited intervention is mainly behind this reversal in the capital flight. So I think we should really thank Mario Draghi here.
As economic stability returns to the region, the euro is continuing its climb towards two-year highs. And as fears of a eurozone break seem to have passed, assets in the region are offering more attractive yields. Nick Parsons is head of market strategy at NAB.
If the ECB stands ready, as it does, to activate its OMT program if asked, then I think investors have got much less to fear in peripheral Europe than they might have previously. It seems to us that the vast majority of austerity will now be spoken about in the past tense rather than being a threat for the future.
But a complete turnaround in sentiment may take some time. The inflows seen at the end of last year are dwarfed by the outflows that have battered the Eurozone's poorest countries.
We may see further improvements in the first 2 months of this year, but obviously sentiment in the financial market could easily deteriorate again. There are still some problems, obviously, with Cyprus, but let's hope that indeed this trend continues and that in 1 or 2 years' time we can indeed say that that this was indeed a turning point of the euro crisis. But for now, I think it's still a bit too premature to say that.
Italy's six-month borrowing costs tumbled to their lowest in nearly 3 years at a bond auction on Tuesday, as investors continue to snap up its debt. And German consumer sentiment rose for the first time in 4 months. For now, the lull in the eurozone storm continues.